Hi, in this tutorial we are going to show you how to program your own client connectors. Especially connectors for REST API for getting list of all possible objects in your RTLS. And WebSocket API for getting position data and other information from tags. We are going to look at the API documentation first. It could be accessed from our RTLS Studio. There is an interactive demo with every endpoint of our API. For example, if we would like to get the list of all anchors, we simply call our anchors endpoint with get method. The response and all the data are documented in this demo. Why don't we try writing our own REST API client connector for getting all feeds? Let's begin with a blank web page with opened console window. On the right side we have a JavaScript file of this web page. First of all, we are going to define our constants. This is an IP address of your RTLS server. This is an API key for accessing our data. Then we are going to create a function for getting all feeds. We are going to need XML HTTP request. If the query was successful, we are going to call our callback function with the data we received. As stated in the API documentation, we are going to send blank get method on our server IP/sendsMapServer/API/feeds. Let's call our function and print the response in our callback. As you can see, there are 4 objects received from our server. One anchor, two tags, and one building with one plan. You can go through the data if you want. The WebSocket documentation could be accessed from RTLS Studio as well. All information is provided in this documentation. We are going to write our own tag subscription. Let's create another function. This one will subscribe to our tag feed. It could be done using Websocket. Websocket service is by default running on port 8080. Then again, we are going to pass the response message to our defined callback. The message we are going to send to our WebSocket is following format. There are three keys: headers, method, and resource. In headers, we are going to specify our API key. In method, we are going to select subscribe method. And in resource, we are going to specify what resource we would like to subscribe to. In this case, it is our feed ID. Finally, we are going to call our function. Okay, let's move our tag a little bit. These are the tag data from our server. There is X position, Y position, CLR, which has value over 9000 because we only have one anchor for presence detection, and in the last place the quaternion rotation of our tag because we have rotation enabled in our tag sensor setting. If you want to receive raw data of your tag, please reconfigure it via RTLS Manager. Here is the example of what raw data looks like in our client application. Stay tuned and thanks for watching.